Hi everyone, in this video we will upload a log to Splunk Enterprise and analyze it. Splunk Enterprise is a platform to collect, analyze, and visualize machine-generated data. This data includes log files, application metrics, network data, and industrial data to name a few. In this tutorial we will focus on log files. Log files are computer-generated data files that serve as a primary data source for the information related to activities, operations, and usage patterns about applications, servers, operating systems, or other devices. Log files provide a detailed record of every action and provide insights to help identify the root cause of problems or anomalies. In this tutorial, we will work with a small CSV file uploaded to Splunk and analyze and visualize the data. The log sizes within the tutorial are relatively small. In reality, logs can have millions of data points over a single day. You can find the log files in the GitHub repo linked in the description below. Let us get into the tutorial. Right now, I am in the Splunk Enterprise homepage. I am going to upload my CSV of server data by clicking the Add Data option. There are a few choices in ingesting data within Splunk. I am going to choose Upload, and this will prompt us to upload a file. I am going to click the Select File button, and I am going to upload my CSV file into Splunk. We can see that my file uploaded successfully, and to continue, I am going to hit Next. We have our Set Source Type page. By default, Splunk will attempt to detect the file type you are trying to upload. We can see that Splunk is able to detect that we have uploaded a CSV file. Splunk will also try to categorize the data. For instance, we have our time column. Splunk set the column as a date time variable. If the default settings are incorrect for your data, you can modify them. For example, in the timestamp column, you can add a time zone. For the delimited settings, you can specify the delimiter. And for the advanced settings, you could specify the line breaks for the data, the character encoding if your data is non-UTF-8, and timestamp controls using regex if Splunk is not correctly identifying the timestamps. Moving on, we have the input settings page. We have a few options for our host field. The constant value option, which I will use, sets a distinct name for the host. The host field value should be the name of the machine that the data is retrieved from. I will label my host as on-prem servers. For the regular expression on path option, a regex pattern needs to be defined to extract the host value from the file path. For the segment in path option, the host value can be extracted from a specific part of the file path. Next, we have to define our index. Splunk will store the data from our logs as events in a given index. I will create a new index. In the new index page, we can configure the properties for our index. I will name the index servers. For our index data type, we can choose to label the data as events or metrics. Events usually contain text describing an occurrence, for example, a log file or an error log for a computer. Metrics are optimized for numeric time series data, such as an application that counts the number of steps a wearer takes or CPU usage over time for a machine. In our case, we have a log, so I will set the data type as events. There are additional configuration settings we can set. The home path is the path where hot and warm buckets are stored. Splunk defines hot buckets as data that is currently being written and indexed and are frequently accessed. Once the hot bucket reaches a specified size, it is rotated to a warm bucket, where the data is searchable but is not currently being written to. The cold path is for older data that is not accessed as frequently. The thawed path is for old data that has not been accessed for a long time and is restored. The data integrity check can be used for sensitive data, where Splunk creates a hash to verify the index data. The max size of the index sets the storage size for the index. Once the index reaches that size, the oldest data is frozen or deleted. I will leave the remaining settings at their defaults. We are prompted to review our index. Everything looks good, so I will create the index. We successfully created our index. I am now going to go to the Splunk Enterprise homepage. We can now search our data in Splunk. I am going to select Search and Reporting. From here, we can search our data. On the right, I can configure the time period I want to search. I am going to change this from 24 hours to all time. Please note, if you are working with real-time data, you may want to have a smaller period of time because you can have millions of data points and this can cause issues with performance. We can search the data by putting in index and then setting it equal to the name of the index, which is servers. I now have all of the events listed for the server log, and then in the leftmost column, we have the time that the event took place. For the next search, I am going to aggregate and display a count of all the events based on their event type. For the search, we just have three events, a login, logout, and error event. Selecting the events, you can drill down further to get more information on them. We can also visualize our searches. I am going to search for events over a specified period of time, then I am going to create a chart from the search. We have our events listed for the specified period of time. If I click on the Visualization tab, I can visualize my search. Here we have a bar chart. On the x-axis, we have the event date, and then on the y-axis, we have the count of events per date. I can further break out the bar chart by specifying I want the events listed by event type. Now for a given day, we have the events broken out by event type, where an event can be a login, a logout, or an error. For the visual, we can also change the chart type. I am going to change it from a bar chart to a line chart. I will create one last visual. I am going to create a pie chart that is going to list the count of each event. And we have our pie chart. This brings us to the end of our tutorial. To summarize, we learned how to upload data to Splunk, how to create an index, basic searches to analyze our log, and visualizations to graph our data. Within the GitHub repo, I have a PDF workshop that goes through additional analysis on a synthetic Microsoft Azure log. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope that this video was helpful. In the description, I link the documentation site for Splunk Enterprise. If you found this video helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. You can also connect with me on LinkedIn, X, GitHub, Medium, and Odyssey. I also have a new podcast called The Aspiring STEM Geek, which you can check out on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Audible, and iHeartRadio. Thanks again, everyone, and happy coding.